So I'm the training manager for Down Syndrome UK and Positive About Down Syndrome. And we're joined today as well by Julie Duff, who is from Down Syndrome Cheshire. Unfortunately, I've got to rush off to do a webinar somewhere else in a minute. So Julie is on the National Down Syndrome Policy Group alongside a lot of alongside Nicola Enoch and myself from Down Syndrome UK, and she's very kindly offered to step in to host this webinar on our behalf. So I welcome Julie to the team. So if we go into the next slide, so today we've got these four young people with Down syndrome are going to speak to you. We've got Bethany Asher, who's an actress. We've got Noah Matthews, who sent us a video. Because he's at school, he's doing his GCSEs, but he's got some exciting tales to tell about being in a Disney movie. The first person with Down syndrome to be in a Disney movie. We've got Rula. Rula has got some really exciting things to say about the book that she's been involved with, and we've got Carmela, who you may recognise, who was in is in Born to Perform, who won the Golden Buzzer at the Britain's Got Talent. But it's not just about those massive successes. They're just going to tell you about their general lives and what they've been up to, and what they like about their lives and what they struggle with. So I'll introduce you to them in a moment, or Julie will. So next slide. Thanks, Julie. In case you've not been to any of our webinars before, Down Syndrome UK is a national organisation. We have an arm of Down Syndrome UK, which is Positive About Down Syndrome, which is more of our maternity kind of healthcare professional side of the charity. So we've been going nearly 7 years now. That's our founder, Nicola Enoch, there, who's alongside me and Julie are part of the National Down Syndrome Policy Group that are supporting Liam Fox in the movement of the Down Syndrome Act in England. But as a national organisation, we've done an awful lot in those few years that we've been going. We've done a lot of research into how women were given the news that their baby has Down syndrome, also a lot on mental health of mothers of children with Down syndrome and breastfeeding. We've had various research published in the British Journal of Midwifery. Next slide, Julie. So we're a parent-led charity, and as such, we consider ourselves to be experts through experience. We provide information not just to parents but to professionals as well. We do training like this, more extensive training into Down syndrome, the importance of language, but also breastfeeding, various training opportunities we're able to provide professionals. But we also provide parents with information sharing sessions on areas that they might need support in bringing up children with Down syndrome. As I said, we also campaign and lobby. We've got a load of literature. Do look on our website because this isn't about what support we're able to provide today. This is more about our people with Down syndrome sharing their stories. But do have a look at our website, how we might be able to help you as professionals going forward. So as you know, just even over the last 15 years when I've been part of this community, the times are changing for people with Down syndrome, and people with Down syndrome, as you will hear, are now able to achieve more and more. And that's down to a lot of research into the way people with Down syndrome learn and the early intervention programs that they're able to access at an early age, early speech sounds and occupational therapy inputs. And we're hoping that the Down Syndrome Act in England will also make a big difference to the quality of life of people with Down syndrome and giving them more of a place in society. So as you will find out from listening to our speakers today, many people with Down syndrome are leaving home, forming relationships, working, and have the usual kind of expectations for their lives that everybody else has. In terms of working, a lot of people learning disabilities, it's less than 7% of people with learning disabilities have paid work. So that's something that we're hoping to that the Down Syndrome Act may help. But a lot of well are these people with Down syndrome will tell you more about what they do with their lives and what they're able to do and what they like to do. So I think we're moving straight on now to Beth the next. Yeah. So I'm going to just say goodbye and say thank you. for joining us today, and I'll leave you in the capable hands of Julie Duff, who's going to introduce our fantastic speakers today. Thank you. Bye.
Thanks, Lou. Thanks for the introduction. So our first speaker up today is going to be Beth. I'm not going to steal her thunder. I'm going to let Beth describe her life in her own words. If anybody would like to ask any of the speakers any questions, then please do feel free to put it in the chat and we can pose the questions to them. Or indeed, if you've got any questions at all about Down syndrome that you would like any responses to, then again, pop them in the chat and we can, if we've got a chance, we'll answer them at the end. But if not, we will get back to you and let you know. But without further ado, please may I introduce the wonderful Beth. Over to you, Beth.
So, hi, it's lovely to meet you all today. I'm Bethany Asher, I'm 28 years old, and I live in Leicestershire. I would like to share with you with some of my life experiences. My mum didn't know I had Down syndrome until I was born in 1995. She was 26. The midwife told my mum that she felt sad for her because she was so young that she'd have a baby for life. She was talking about me. The doctor told my mum it was like ordering a Rolls Royce, but getting a Mini. He was talking about me. My mum wasn't buying it. My development was pretty much the same as other children. I could sit up, stand and walk at the same time as them. My speech was good. I can read very well and I have a good imagination. I've dreamt of one day being an actress. And it happened in 2018. That happened. I got an agent. In 1 month, I was cast in BBC Doctors. I went on to do a film called Innocence, where I played a girl who was being sexually abused in a care home. I have worked with Gemma Arterton in a film about a girl who was accused of witchcraft. In the 1700s, I did an ITV show called Wild Bill with Rob Lowe. My mum says he was a heartthrob back in the 1980s. He was lots of fun. I was in Doctors for two more times. Also, because of tea last year, where I played a woman with Down syndrome who was pregnant and roomed. That she, the baby would be taken away from her. It was very powerful. Last summer, I filmed my biggest role in BBC show drama Sherwood, series two, which you can see this summer. I worked with David Morrissey, Monica Dolan, David Harewood and many other big names. I was treated as equal and felt very valued, respected by everybody. I love exploring characters, backstories, finding out about that person and their relationships with others. I get to explore different emotions. And characters who are nothing like me at all. Some of my characters have experience like I never have. You need to be able to love what you do. You need to do just enjoy it and let your imagination go wild. Prepare before, but when you're on set, anything can go happen. Happen. Just go with it. We are seeing more learning disability people for, but we shall are underrepresented compared to others. I believe we need to change storylines. It's easy to tick a box. Sometimes people see me, us as one dimensional. I like to be challenged. I have been lucky enough to have some great storylines like abuse, baby loss, witchcraft, and we need more characters like that. I did a film where there was no mention of my Down syndrome at all. The role, because I was cast because I fitted the role. I played a girl who had lost a baby. It was refreshing. I felt people saw past my label. I was just right for the role. I believe that I have shown the doctors and nurses not to put me in a box. One size doesn't fit at all, and I am proof of that. People see my face and judge me before getting to know me. All they see is Down syndrome. I challenge you all today to question your narrative and your experiences when you see a child with Down syndrome. Kick away that box and see us all as individuals. Thank you for listening today.
Absolutely amazing. Well done, Beth. If anybody can find their clappy emojis, that was absolutely spectacular. And what a life you have lived in such short years. Blimey. And I've got to disagree. I think Rob Lowe is still very much a heartthrob. Tell you, very jealous that you've managed to meet him. Thank you very, very, very much indeed. That was absolutely brilliant. I'm now going to do my best to put a video on from Noah. And Noah's got an exceptional story too. Noah, just bear this in mind. Noah can't come today because he's 16 and he's doing his GCSEs. So yet another young life lived to the full. And let's hear about his life in his own words. So I'm going to, hopefully everybody's going to be able to hear my screen. Fingers crossed the technology works. So here's Noah.
Hey, Noah. What do you like about your life?
I remember the 24th of September 2007 when I was born in a hospital in Worthing. And then my parents drove me all the way down here to have the best time ever of your life. I grew up from a very Jewish family and my Northern family. I love them both equally. That's how they made me.
And what's school like?
The school is pretty mainstream. Yeah. I made some friends as well. And also got head boy as well. Yeah, life's going great at school for a minute.
Are you doing any exams this year?
Well, maybe some GCSEs this year.
What GCSEs are you taking?
I'm taking drama and I'm a core shop sex. Yeah. And photography as well.
And Noah, you were in Peter Pan and Wendy.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, you were the first act with Down syndrome to be in a Disney film. What was that like? And how is it being famous?
It all started when me and my mum were drove in a limo all the way to the airport. When we get to the airport, we get some VIP lounge. When the plane was landed, we get on the plane and see some other people who also got doing the same project as us. It was pretty fun. And then when we get to Toronto, and then for pit stop, and then we eventually went to Vancouver after, and it was pretty fun. They have a swimming pool and a gym downstairs. Boy, it was amazing. And also met two funny characters that drove us to Mammoth Studios. On our first day of set, we get into our costumes and had a photo shoot. It was pretty fun. Even though you still in a Disney movie, that still doesn't mean you have to, that does mean you have to do your schoolwork. I met a very funny classic TA named Jesse. Oh boy, he was funny. And his brother too, I'm a medic as well.
And when you came back to school, Noah, did people ask for your autograph?
Every person I must go wanted a hug from me, a signature, and a photo with me.
And did you like that?
Yes, I did.
And tell me, what do you find easy?
Life. Yeah.
What are your hobbies?
I do like playing piano, hanging out with family, water sports, and some cricket and basketball as well.
And what about, are there any things that you struggle with?
No, I do not. I don't have anything to struggle with.
What about, do you sometimes find maths hard and money and things like that?
A little bit, but not much.
What do you want for your future, Noah?
Hopefully some more acting jobs, because I love doing them and seeing new people. And also, don't let Down Syndrome hold you back. Decide what you want from life, then go and do it.
Thank you, Noah. Oh, one last thing. Why are you patron of PADS?
Because I love to try new things in my life. If PADS is one of them, I love to be an ambassador for them.
Thank you, Noah. That's great.
Wow. Is anybody else feeling inferior on this call with those two fantastic speakers already? Well, thank you, Noah, for sharing your story as well. We have two more. Let me just see if I can move on to the next one. Hold on a sec.
Hey, Noah.
Bear with me, the technology people. Here we go. Just bring up our next wonderful speaker, who is going to blow you away equally as much as both Beth and Noah has. I'm going to hand you over to the wonderful Carmella. Carmella, tell us all about you and your life.
Hello, my name is Carmella. I'm 25 years old. I live in Devonshire with my mum, dad, my younger sister Mia, and our four dogs. We have four cockapoos, Belle, Will, Luna and Riley. We are really mad but cute. I also have an older sister called Alicia. She lives in Daventry as well with her boyfriend. Actually, recognised me 3 years ago and was on Britain's Got Talent, dancing with some friends from Born to Perform, which is performing arts day centre I attend anyway. We went to the audition in London. We were so nervous, but we did really well and got the golden buzzer from David Williams. It was so exciting. So we got through to the live semi-finals. We worked really, really hard. And in the morning of the semi-final, I was interviewed on This Morning on live TV. We didn't make it through to the final, but we did do really well and had a great time. Since then, we performed at many awards shows, exhibitions, events, and in the community. I have a really fun life. I go to Bond to perform 2 days a week, where we do lots of dancing, yoga, samba, singing, acting, and dancing to songs. I go to Brookside Day Centre 3 days a week, and we do cooking, baking, dancing, acting, photography. I also did a customer services course, and before COVID, I used to do a shift in Starbucks each week. I volunteer for a few hours each week on a Monday evening with acting children at this prison youth club. I set up, run and serve at the top shop, help with activities and do the hoovering. I really love going to those nights. My boyfriend, friends and to have a meal. I have a few glasses of wine and we do karaoke. It's so much fun. I have a boyfriend called Mark. We met at college and we have been together for 4.5 years. We have date night each week. We go to day centres together 4 days a week. One day we want to get engaged, married and live together. We love each other very much. My best friend is called Kerry. We have been best friends since we were 14. We met when I finished at mainstream school and I attend a special needs school. We have lots of fun together and talk on FaceTime all the time. I have a personal assistant called Harriet. We've known each other since we were at nursery. We go out together to a pub, bowling, cinema, bingo, and sometimes we go shopping for food together and cook a meal at her house. I'm a passenger for a dozen spring that is called Wooden Drink Thing. We've made scientist song videos for social media. We've also been shown on TV this morning. Our photos and videos are used to produce lots of social media posts to help to improve awareness of Down syndrome. I'm also on the National Down Syndrome Policy Advisory Group. And last week, I was really lucky. I went to 10 Downing Street to celebrate World Down Syndrome Day. We are helping with petitions to write the Down Syndrome Act. It was really fun day. My favourite thing is to do is to get dressed up, go out with friends and family for a meal, cocktails and a dance just for the same as most girls of my age. And thank you so much for listening to me. I'm happy to answer any questions you might have about my life.
And everybody find those clapping emojis again. Well done, Carmella. That was absolutely brilliant. And I'm loving to see that smiling face of yours as well. That's absolutely wonderful. Tell you what, Carmella, we're going to ask everybody any questions at the end, okay? So any questions of yourself, Beth or Rula, we're going to save those to the end. And you can have a chance to answer them then, if that's okay. Yeah, I am feeling even more inadequate now, the fact that you've been on Britain's Got Talent this morning and whatever else. I tell you, we are in a group of very talented people here. Okay, I think we're probably saving the best till last, so aren't we, Rula?
Yeah, I think so, anyway.
I think so, too. You are up next. So with no further ado, I'm going to introduce the wonderful Rula. Thanks ever so much, Rula. Handing over to you.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Rula and I'm 37 years old. I was born in Cyprus in 1986. At that time, my father was a teacher there with Service Children's Education. I want to tell you about my life. Prepare to be surprised. Some of the things I'm passionate about are music, and I would say I have quite an eclectic taste in music. That means varied and wide-ranging. I like classical, like Bach and Beethoven, the art of jazz, like French Jazz Cafe, Nina Simone, Billie Holiday, Louis Armstrong and Mel Torme. But pop music is my favourite, from George Michael to Shania Twain and Michael Jackson. I love watching films, and I believe they can make you laugh and raise your mood. I love how they can impact your life. I like Little Women, and I'm a huge fan of Audrey Hepburn. I'm always watching Funny Face, Breakfast at Tiffany's, My Fair Lady, and Sabrina, but also Harry Potter, Mamma Mia, and The Devil Wears Prada. I love gardening, and we have a big garden. It's my happy place. I feel spiritual there. I'm very proud of my herb bed. It has fennel, sage, caraway, rosemary, and thyme. Gardening has a calming effect on me. I can read down there for hours. For me, books and reading are very important. I've always loved books. I love feeling the pages when I turn them. And I've always loved going into bookshops. I met Imogen Smallwood who is Enid Blyton's granddaughter. I loved the books of Jacqueline Wilson, but also the natural history of Selborne and the poetry of John Clare. I can get lost in the book and dive in and enter other worlds. I couldn't live without books. Writing is very important to me. Now, looking back to my childhood, I was always writing. A favourite book now is Always Take Notes, advice from some of the world's greatest writers. And here it is. And I am taking their advice. But the most exciting thing for me recently has been working with a professional author called Mel Darbin, whose first three novels are about giving a voice to people who don't usually have one. I acted as a sensitivity reader for her first book, which won 20 awards and was nominated for the Carnegie Medal. Mel's third book, Saving Arthur, will be published later this year. And guess what? This time my name will be on the cover. How cool is that? I'm hoping this will be a step towards my ambition of becoming an author myself one day. This will be truly life-changing for me. I love to dance, and I believe a lot of Down syndrome people like dancing. We can't seem to keep still if there's music playing. My family and I are big fans of Strictly Come Dancing. I've been going to a group called Footsteps for 10 years. And I once danced the rumba with Natalie Lowe, one of the Strictly professionals. Pointless changed my life. I was on Pointless in 2016. I went viral on social media. 1,500 hits on Facebook. Hashtag find ruler. For me, life changed radically. After being on Pointless, I was contacted by Lynn Murray of the charity Don't Screen Us Out. I joined the National Down Syndrome Policy Group, and I helped write the guidance for the new Down Syndrome Act. I went with other members to Downing Street. Last year, I went to the Crick Institute, the launch of a film called Lost Voices, to which I contributed. I also got involved in an installation at the Science Museum called Effective, Defective, Creative. Last year, I was part of the GOAT-DS21 study in the health of Down syndrome people at King's College. This year, I'll be part of a study called Horizon 21, involving 11 European universities in 9 locations across Europe. Things are now really moving in the Down syndrome world. At least we are cooking on gas. This time, about harming the environment. Of course, there are potentially many struggles in the lives of people who have Down syndrome, and like others, I've had my share. For instance, bereavements. Before we left Cyprus to return to the UK for good, my friend Hannah died in a jet ski accident there. We had to postpone our flight home, then attend her funeral in the UK. My Down syndrome friend, Joe, from Shrewsbury, developed cysts in her brain and died in a Birmingham hospital not long afterwards. Another funeral followed. When my grand died in 2009, aged 100, I was the most upset of all, and I still am. We had a very special bond. She's my best friend and confidant, so I could share anything on my mind. I even made a speech at her funeral, a wonderful lady. Travelling independently, I can't read a bus or train timetable, so finding my way to places would be hard. Knowing where to get off would be hard to remember. I don't like hospitals because it reminds me of visiting parents or friends in hospital is always sad for me. I hate MRI scans, the noise and the judging. People underestimating me. Some of my strengths are reading, handwriting and spelling. General knowledge, not bad. Sometimes I can answer questions on university challenge. Just last night, I answered a question on 12th night. People don't think a person with Down syndrome can be articulate and well-spoken, but I'm immersed in words all the time. Dealing with money, it's hard for me to decide whether things are worth the money. Hard to know whether I've been given the right change when buying things. And I'm scared I might lose my debit card or I might get scammed. Moving to a new area to live. We might move to Lincoln to be near my brother and his family. How will I get used to a new area? And how long will that take? Will we have nice neighbours? Find new friends? Find a paid job? I have good IT skills, but couldn't find a job here. Abortion. I am upset by the current laws on abortion because of the effect they may have on babies with Down syndrome. The current time limit for legal abortions is up to 24 weeks, and it should be the same for everyone, but it isn't yet, and that's not true equality. You have one life, and I love mine. Thank you.
Wow, that was amazing, Rula. So very articulate. Again, find your clapping hands, everybody.
Thanks, guys.
Absolutely astonishing. Wow, well done. Thank you. Okay, so this is your opportunity to ask any of our speakers, Carmela, Rula, or Beth, about any parts of their life that you may have. And I'm going to ask Tracy if there's any questions that have come up.
We've mainly had everybody asking, everybody thanking you all for sharing your stories. Lots of emojis and a lot of thank yous. As of yet, we haven't got any questions. So if anybody has any, do pop them in the chat or unmute or raise your hand. Just lots of thanks coming in.
I know. I think we're all feeling a little bit inadequate after hearing all of their speeches, to be fair. My life is very dull in comparison to you three or you four. So if you do have any questions, then please do. I'm sure our speakers will be happy to answer any. But I am very conscious of time, and I know that you guys have dialed in during lunch break. So I will move on to the next slide. Everybody is just bigging you guys up, saying how much they've actually loved listening to you. So thank you very much indeed for all of you sharing your stories. Okay, come on, technology, please work. Okay, so before we leave, we just wanted to make sure that everybody knew how to find us if they want any other further information. I'm going to, again, Tracy, if that's okay with you, I'm going to ask you to put a link into the chat so that people can actually find the website. The website is Down Syndrome UK, and it has an awful lot of resources on there. It talked about Down syndrome in 2024. We also have a Positive About Down Syndrome closed Facebook page, so please do feel free to search that out. And you can see on there, there's over 600 members. It's a safe space where professionals can ask questions with regards to Down syndrome. And if you guys would like to join it, there will be a few questions, I believe, beforehand, and then and a few rules that you might have to follow, but they, it is all there for you to find out. Okay. Let me just double checking if there's anything else. Okay, we've had people saying what fascinating speeches that was. So helpful to listen to your experiences. Well done, guys. There is a link in the chat to Down Syndrome UK. And there's a few people that are having to log off now. So I'm just going to wrap up. Those are the contact details. Please do take a picture of the screen if you want to find out any more. And you can also email Lou, who is on the call at the beginning, directly at that email address there, or get hold of her. So I think that probably that all that is left to say to everybody is thank you for your time. Thank you for coming along today. And a special shout out to Carmela, Rula, Beth and Noah for sharing their exceptional lives and their exceptional stories. Thank you very much indeed, everybody.